Hey folks, welcome back to my channel. This is GamerVictorious. We're playing Chapter 7, the Magic Chisel.
I don't think we should disturb Jormungandr without some reason.
God of War, Kratos, and his son Atreus. In their companion Mimir, the Hand, as they are in search of the Magic Chisel, on their way to find it and to go to the new destination, which is Jotunheim.
So when we get to the boat, we can either look for that special chisel now.
Share and leave a comment and enjoy this gameplay video.
Which way to the chisel?
Keep rowing towards the statues of the oarsmen, then thread past between them.
Mimir, you never did tell me why Freya spit in your face.
Well, she blames me in large measure for her present circumstances, and not totally without reason. It all goes back to the long war between the Aesir and Vanir. Prior to that, wars with Aesir were easily won, but the Vanir had proved their equal and exacted devastating damage.
Enough. Our focus is the road.
Completely understand. I'll finish later, lad. Wondered what became of him.
Wait, Fafnir? Like, Fafnir's storeroom Fafnir?
The very one.
But Sindri said he was a dwarf.
He was. And now he's a dragon. Funny how life works, isn't it?
He's chained up.
Perhaps we should keep an eye out for binding shrines and free the poor bastard. Aye, lads?
Become a dragon, Mimir.
Oh, he's no friend of mine. This little scrote was a constant source of annoyance amongst Aesir and Vanir alike.
Then why free him?
Trust the recently liberated brother. No one deserves to be held captive like this. Even a greedy dwarf can drag. Thank you.
always question had. How did this dwarf become a dragon?
Well, I don't know for certain, though I'd wager his penchant for stealing magical artifacts had something to do with it. Must have stolen a trinket from the wrong Vanir goddess.
Boy.
Okay, that's going in the journal.
Behind you!
I can't get!
Roll free, Panda!
threat to the dwarves.
Think he'll remember you?
I don't know, lad. A lot's changed since we last crossed paths. I had legs.
Was difficult.
Sir.
You wee little bugger. Well, the dragon hasn't done much for his personality.
we were in a boat, and we just started the story. What did you want to tell me about the Long War?
Both sides suffered tremendous losses. And for many of us, quite frankly, war was simply no fun anymore. But a rather senseless waste of precious life. But I can just tell you this story later.
Ah, good. The special chisel is ahead, past this gate.
Here we go!
Among the living, my beloved Gulvig calls to me. She yearns for peace, yet her remains lie in pieces. I beg of you, make my Gulvig whole again.
You want us to collect her bones? Gross.
Gulvig's Sather magic knows no bounds. She can reunite you with those you've lost.
Really? How?
Boy,
I can smell your grief, child. Rest assured, her magic is strong enough to create bridges between life and death, if only for a short while.
Boy, we are leaving.
They've taken three of Sweet Gulvig's bones and spread them across the lake. Bring me her bones, child. Gulvig will reward you.
Father? Maybe we should look for those bones.
Why?
Didn't you hear him? We could talk to Mom again. If we keep an eye out
look
while
we... Look if you wish, boy. I will not be distracted by this fool's errand.
Mimir, you were in the middle of a story before. What were you saying about the Long War?
Enough was enough. And at last, Odin's most brilliant advisor became determined to find a more enlightened path.
You what?
I'll tell this one later.
These bones pulse with magic.
It must be Gulvig. Could we just hold on to it? Maybe we'll find the rest of them.
This spirit lies to you, boy.
How would you know?
I have known many spirits. They are all liars.
This one is different. I know it.
You know very little.
Mimir. You were in the middle of a story before. So, how did this advisor of Odin's try to end the Long War?
He set about to broker a peace between the gods. It took some convincing, but ultimately Odin was persuaded to marry his deadliest enemy, a certain Vanir goddess, legendary not only for her fertile beauty, but her genius and the very Vanir magic that Odin had long aspired to master.
Are you okay?
No, son. My goods are underwater. My men are drowned, and yet their bodies continue to walk the beaches.
Hellwalkers. They plague these lands.
I was their captain. They died, because of me. But these abominations sully their memories. I will find a way to free them from their tortured state. In this, I am determined. The thunder storm scattered all three of my ships across the lake. I know not what I did.
Look here.
Yes, sir. Hey, it's another treasure map. Govi's bones.
What will you say to her?
To Govi?
Your mother. What have you left unsaid?
I just want to know if she's okay.
She is dead, boy.
I know that. You don't understand.
Neither do you.
Soon we'll be able to translate those Muspelheim runes. Hey, look! Looks like there's something written on it. Want me to read it?
Boy.
Yes, sir. Kvekia.
Thank you.
You're very perceptive and reckless. Take caution when lighting these braziers. Sather and Hellwalkers will swarm to the flames like moths. I assume we have you to thank for freeing us from a watery grave.
Us?
Other spirits. The Lake of Nine is full of them. Most are able to move on from this realm, but we, lucky few, are stuck here in Midgard until our affairs are in order. Perhaps you can help them as well.
We have no desire to help you, Spirit.
Ah, but you already have. I only wished to see the sky again. Farewell.
Together.
Straight out of hell.
I discovered opportunities for hunting and trade in these lands. I gave up my search for Jotunheim long ago.
So, I guess we should keep an eye out for other spirits.
What did I say about distractions?
But it sounds like they needed help.
They are spirits, boy. Dead things. They have no needs. Only wants.
It feels wrong to ignore them.
We will get over these feelings.
Mom would have wanted to help them.
What was that, boy?
Nothing.
I thought as much.
Mimir, you were in the middle of a story before. How would Freya agree to marry Odin? What was in it for her?
It was a sacrifice to protect her people. A selfless act of love. Truly, she deserves better than she got. But of course, there's more to that story.
We should look for more like this.
Boy.
Sir. Another map. Great.
The final bone.
Yeah.
We might as well return them to the spirit. Maybe he will keep his word.
I know she's not coming back, okay? I know. I just... Never mind. I just gotta return the bones.
Well, I forgot.
You want to dock here? Not getting in there without a key.
Despite his mountainous size, was without question the greatest stonemason this world had ever seen. Proud Thamur hoped to one day pass his vast knowledge onto his son, but young Hrimthur had the heart of a warrior. Perhaps the father had too much fear in him, or the son too little. Either way, a quarrel there spiraled out of control, and the overworked stonemason, bonk, struck his son. Hrimthur ran off into the night. Feeling shame and regret, Thamur chased after his son, but in his emotional state soon found himself wandering Midgard, lost and alone. Sadly, he caught the eye of the one person he didn't want to meet alone that night, so far from home. Thor.
And what happened next?
You'll see.
Thor killed him. Oh no. He fell in the village?
Aye. When Thamur fell, he crushed a charming place famed for worshipping the Vanir god Njord. Thor always took credit for planning that one. The truth is, the sweaty ball bag just got lucky.
Enemies ahead!
Of one, yes. A very, very giant chisel.
Darn, that didn't seem to do anything.
Brother, looks like that crystal's brimming again. Oh, neat trick, lad.
Thanks. His idea.
Oh, Thamur was a frost giant. When he died, his final breath froze everything. Find the tip of that chisel. That's the magic we need.
Enemies. Are we doing this? Ready to go now!
Ready!
weak, Bungle! staying around here.
Correct.
But how do we move forward? Boy, armor really liked you.
I happen to think he looks dashing. You know, for a snow-covered corpse.
So, this plan of yours?
Can you guess it?
Knowing you, it doesn't involve standing around here.
Correct.
But how do we move forward? Heading into that building?
Yes.
You think there's something inside that'll help us break the ice and get to the chisel tip?
No.
I'll keep thinking.
Enemies ahead!
I came here on a diplomatic mission once, trying to broker a peace between Asgard and Vanaheim. That war. So many lives lost. What I didn't know was Thor had already gone on a killing spree of giants.
What did the giants have to do with the war between the gods?
Nothing at all, lad. That's the tragedy of it. They took no side in that madness. But Odin's paranoia is surpassed only by Thor's lust for blood.
Thank you. Another crystal. Give the word. Huh. What now?
Stealthy planet is not.
Now we must free the other strap.
We do? Why are we going up when what we need is all the way down there?
Think.
Well, the chisel tip is under thick layers of ice, so melting it won't work.
Correct.
And there weren't any shattered crystals nearby for me to shoot, so that's not an option.
Correct.
That just leaves smashing the ice. We need something ridiculously heavy to... Oh, I get it.
Good.
How are we going to turn the hammer so it lands near the chisel tip?
Not possible. We cut it free, write it down, and figure out what comes next after.
So your plan involves a whole bunch of luck.
You are welcome to suggest a different one. Tight.
This plan seems ill-advised.
Wait. Jump!
That didn't work. It only fell a little ways. There's a sand bowl, but how do we get to it?
We cannot. Boy. What does it say?
When time itself is deserted, the forward path is retrograde. Retrograde? It's backwards?
Those symbols. The seasons?
Yeah, but the order's all jumbled. Shouldn't it be winter, spring, summer, autumn?
Why start with winter?
It's from a song Mother used to sing.
Do I know that one? Winter!
Quiet, Head.
Doesn't like music either. Got it.
Do it.
Var. House. Vetter. Sumo. No, that wasn't right.
There.
Vower, House, Vetter, Subar. Still nothing.
Boy, the order from the song again.
Winter, spring, summer, autumn.
Try that.
housed.
Retrograde, lads.
What?
Of course. The riddle. The answer is reversed. Atreus, that word.
Thola. It means endure.
Try it.
Thola.
Well done, lad.
Write it again.
Thola. Horizon! The energy's lifting the platform!
Keep writing.
Thola. Thola. Thola.
Head. How is this possible?
My guess? Temporal magic. Dangerous stuff the High Vanir gods used to play around with. The ability to freeze time. Happened to be a favorite of Njord himself, in fact.
Used to? Why did they stop?
Well, turns out stopping time keeps the sun and moon from streaking across the sky. Unfortunately, it does not stop the wolves that chase them, always looking to sink their teeth in. After that, they decided it was best to leave time alone.
Floor collapses.
Yeah.
jump! You did well.
Thanks.
The boy.
Just having a little fun, you big grump.
Well, there it is. How are we going to get it free?
A push. Trust me. Ready. Dig in and push with everything.
Yes, sir. How do we get down?
We jump.
Really?
Come. Do not panic!
Why would I panic?
Whoa. I have you!
You're cracked, you know that?
Well. Good. We should keep moving.
Credit. He has a talent for destroying things.
Remember that head.
Never leaves my mind.
Those were the guys we saw with Baldur. His nephews?
Aye. Magni and Modi. The sons of Thor.
Mother always said the Aesir were the worst of gods, and Thor was the worst of the Aesir. Guess he's a terrible father, too.
They are no longer children. They have no excuse.
Will Sindri be okay?
We'll never even see him. Ah, the great dining hall. Envy of all Midgard. Funny, I remember there being a massive candelabrum. Really livened up the place.
There.
Ah, yes. You just can't help but break things, can you? Memory serves, the Jarl's throne was just on the other side of that wall of ice.
Come on.
devils are there?
Something ahead.
See, lad? He's fine.
Thought it best to vanish when Thor's idiot sons showed up.
Will you focus on your damn...
Focus and help me find them. Can't disappoint father.
Kaluma!
No, we cannot disappoint father. Now keep looking.
Hurry, brother. We may get a piece of the chisel and be gone before they even notice. Uh-oh.
Yeah.
Boy.
Surrender. The old father demands it.
No. This fight is mine, boy. Go!
And where do you think you're going? Oh no, brother! The little freak's got a bow. What are we gonna do?
Finally! I welcome the challenge.
I can't remember the last time we faced an actual challenge.
You call this a challenge? An old man and this stillborn. I'll take the runt.
You got what you get.
You mean to oppose the might of Asgard? You've got some father, kid. I almost feel bad.
Stay behind me, boy. Why do you hunt us? What does Odin want?
Don't know.
Don't care.
Come here, half-breed. You're done holding that hand.
Shut up! Don't call me that!
You're gonna be all right.
Can't believe you blasted this.
Shut up!
Calm yourself, boy.
Looks like they need another lesson.
Shut it out! Focus!
Yeah!
lips quick. Hold him! Throw him! Lead him! Your mother up there or something? She cut up your face and you'd look at her.
Don't talk about my mother!
Don't talk about my mommy!
Don't listen to him, lad. Trying to rile you up.
Idiot!
Sons of Thor are welcome to try!
Head!
Sorry, overstepped, yeah?
Yeah! Try again, asshole. There's a little run for you.
Stop it!
Boy!
Blood. The boy's sick. He needs Freya.
No!
Steady.
I'll be all right.
There you go, lad.
I'm fine, see?
We should keep an eye on him.
enough?
Should do. With that, we can carve the travel rune to Jotunheim. Get you where you need to go.